What do you do, Libras? Welcome back to my channel. Get you some. It's your girl, Girl King. Happy, wealthy, wonderful Wednesday, Libras. How are all of you? Are you doing well? Libras, sun, moon, rising, north, no, wherever Libra may be sprinkled in your chart, you are welcome here. Hello, new subscribers, my faithful few, and for those of you just breezing on through, what it do? Please like, share, and subscribe. Remember to hit that notification bell so you are aware of when your girl is uploading the next videos for you. Libra, apparently somebody flew too close to the sun, i.e. you. Some years might have passed since you last saw this particular person. Some trees might have grown between you two. Some tears might have fell between you two. But Libra, you're in love with your story. Or so the song says, Icarus by Bass and Ari Lennox. So let's jump into these energies, shall we? Let's get our feet wet, Libra. Dip our toes into these energies and see what might possibly be popping in your universe. Some or all of these messages may or may not resonate with you in this current passage of moments. So Libras, please do only take the messages that vibrate with you. It's not what rings true for you, but most likely it's not what it do. Leave it on the counter. Someone's in a hangman position, energy, Libra. Could it be this person who hasn't seen you in some time? This person who flew too close to the sun? Let's find out. Angels, what's going on for my Libras? Can I get the question off? Apparently the energies are popping, Libra. Angels, what's going on for my Libras? You hear these cards popping? That wanted to fall. We have the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. Hanging out in the deck, we have the Hermit in reverse. We also have a Virtue. The Three of Wands in reverse. Look at all these things hiding in the deck. And we have the Devil in reverse. Whoa, Libra. So something didn't spin in someone's favor. So we have Jupiter energy here with the Wheel, we have Virgo with the Hermit, the Three of Wands is Aries energy, and the Devil is Capricorn. So let's see what's going on, Angels. We have the Ace of Wands in reverse, and we have the Four of Wands in reverse. Twin Flame energies, wow. Let's see what's going on, though. Libra, something didn't spin in somebody's favor. Someone could have been to the fair recently. The fair might be in your town. So somebody laugh now, cry later is coming up. So they were laughing at the time, Libra, when they thought that they were on top of the world, when they thought that they had things under their control. This person thought that they had control of the spin of the wheel. They thought they had control of their destiny, your destiny. I see the Sphinx here. So they thought that they had control over the Empress. This is Empress energy here, and I'm seeing Cleopatra in this card. Some of you may have Egyptian or Kemet origins. This person tried to let it go, Libra, but gosh damn it, you're too much of a ride. You're too much fun, Libra. You're too adventurous. But here comes this lightning strike. So lightning struck twice in this, three times. Lightning struck three times in the same place, and Libra, you said no can do. No can do with this. Laugh now, cry later. So someone's had to face themselves in the mirror. We have the crystal ball. So someone's had to look deeply at the movements that they were making. This controlling energy. Yeah, Jupiter, that is big energy. So these were life-changing events that occurred between you and this person. They don't get no sleep, Libra. It was such a life-altering change that they don't get any sleep, Libra. So sleepless nights. This Virgo. This person is haunted, Libra. So not only are they having sleepless nights, but they are haunted by things that are breaking through the veil. Interesting. So their own demons are catching up to them. Their own demons are after them. This person put their foot on the wrong side of the tracks. Some of you here could take the subway. So much New York energy, boy. I swear a lot of you must be on the East Coast, if not in New York. But here we have Jacob's Ladder. So someone needs some rescuing. Someone here could also be a firefighter, a paramedic, a first responder. Someone needs you to be a first responder. They need some help with their body, their mind, and their spirit, Libra. This person thinks of you as very virtuous. Yeah, the song said, please don't make me cry. I told you, this person has been crying over you. Some tears have fallen in between the years. Some trees have grown in between the years of you seeing this person. And someone is stuck. They've got one foot out the door and one foot in. Again, they've got one foot on the wrong side of the track and one foot not. There's a lot of separation, so you're in separation from this person. A lot of stewing on the pot. This person's horns are showing. But I feel like this person is ready to give up their horns. The pimp hat, their devilish ways, toxicity, negative environments. This bathroom stall looks terrible. This looks like a terrible place to be in. It looks like someone is trapped in between a rock and a hard place, Libra. There are a lot of people around this Capricorn, a lot of people begging for this Capricorn's attention, a lot of people making sacrifices for this Capricorn or towards this Capricorn. Now, I'm not sure what your connection is to this Capricorn just yet, Libra. But it could be this person from your past. Let's see. We have this Ace of Wands in reverse. I just heard no sex. So you may not have had sex with this person. You may have stopped having sex with this person. There was a lack of passion. There's a masculine here with a very long beard. Someone's got spiky hair. Just confirmation on the East. So either you or this person could live on the East Coast. Oh, somebody here might have gotten pregnant. This Capricorn might have gotten pregnant. An Aries might have gotten pregnant. There was discussions over whether or not to keep the baby. So we do have this Four of Wands, which is traditionally considered the twin flame card. So this could be your twin. There could be a pregnancy that you're not aware of, Libra. This Capricorn could have had a baby with an Aries. That was a very fiery situation. Again, they got burnt by the sun. This Capricorn is faced on either side by fire. So this is the rock and the hard place that this person is in. They feel like they have to make a decision, and this person has been stewing. They've been sitting on the pot, and literally in the picture, you see the devil is... Sorry, y'all. My bad, I forgot the light. There we go. And so this person is sitting on the pot. And then we've got this Hermit energy. 1 foot on the track. Hope that's not the electric one. But in between a rock and a hard place, surrounded by fire on all sides. This is why this person may need a firefighter, i.e. a first responder. Someone to put out the flames, to fan the flames. Again, they flew too close to the sun. They caught on fire. Now they need a firefighter. Libra, you are the firefighter. So there was a completion with you and this Capricorn, or something came to a completion between this Capricorn and this Aries. The Capricorn may have cut off sex from this Aries. So the wheels fell off of this situation. This is why the Wheel of Fortune is here, because the wheels fell off between this potential Aries and this Capricorn. We have more Aries energy here with just Four of Wands. That's double confirmation. So, yeah. So, this Capricorn may have had a baby by this Aries. There were talks, maybe discussions over whether or not to keep the baby. I'm not sure if that's what broke up their connection. But yeah, somebody pulled away. I feel like it was the Capricorn that pulled away from the Aries. So this Capricorn didn't feel like doing it again. They didn't feel like going through this cycle again. So this connection with this Aries is over. It's come to its karmic completion. This cycle has ended. Let's see what else is going on, Libras. It says, I'd like to give a big round of applause to my band, Sexual Chocolate. Coming to America, 1988 could be significant. It says, I drink your milkshake. I drink it up. Oh my goodness. It's so forward. It's so forward, Libra. From There Will Be Blood. So this person, like I said, laugh now, cry later. So they were laughing it up, yucking it up, all while having this adventure, taking you for a ride, Libra, because they thought that they had control of the Empress. Whether you be masculine or feminine, man or woman, lady or man, sir or ma'am. Sexual chocolate. Thank you very much. Sexual chocolate. So this person might have viewed you as sexual chocolate, Libra. And they're showing me a chocolate fondue. So even though this person thought that you were sexy fine, Libra, you were sexy fine, you were chocolate, you were saucy. They're showing me the chocolate fondue. So even though this person thought that you were saucy, you were chocolatey, you were sexy, they went in search of a chocolate fondue machine. Where they could just have fondue just 24/7. Laugh now, cry later. So they're crying now. It says, I drink your milkshake. I drink it up. Now, milkshakes can be a plethora of, we'll just say it's a synonym. So somebody was drinking some milkshakes, Libra. whether made with cow's milk or man's milk. Anywho, we have this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy here. This water. Water on this Virgo. So there's blood in the water, Libra. There's blood in the water because somebody was thirsty. Oh, goodness. Somebody was thirsty, Libra. There's too many people here. There's one too many people here. There's two too many people here. How about that? There's two too many people here. The Aries and the Virgo. I don't know where they came from. We'll move on. It says, life comes down to a few moments. This is one of them from Wall Street. More drama, more Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, water energy. So life comes down to a few moments. Their life is on fire, Libra. Their life is on fire. They need you to be their first responder to come help them mend their body, their mind, their spirit. They've been walled up. We have this hermit energy right next to Wall Street. So this person may have backed away from the streets. This person may not be running around town like they used to. Because what do fire trucks do? Fire trucks don't normally just sit up in the fire station. Normally, you know, if there's an emergency, that fire truck is on the street. So this is in a reverse. So this person has been at home. They turned into a wallflower. So there's been a reversal in this person's energy, the way that they move. They've been thinking a lot. They've been in hermit. But they're ready to come out of hermit. They're ready to receive help. They're ready to step away from these devilish entities or energies. This person has been abstaining, or at least abstaining from this Aries that they might have possibly gotten pregnant with. Someone here could have been born in 1987. We have, it's not that I'm lazy, it's that I just don't care from Office Space. So again, this person felt or feels closed in by this situation. And this is why this person is disengaging from a very fiery situation. Because again, wherever they look, there is fire on all sides. And that may have been what kept this person stuck and stagnant and sitting on the pot for a while. They didn't know which way to go, because it's like when you're caught in a fire and you're in the forest and the fire has surrounded you, it's like, what fucking direction do you run? Every direction you look in, there's fire over there, there's fire over there, there's fire behind me, there's fire this way. It's like, which way do I go? So that had this person stuck for a while, trying to figure out what was the best and most direct route out and away from fiery situations on all sides. I'm feeling that this person, even though they want to reach out to you, Libra, because it's been some time since you two have been in separation, this person is learning to have to be their own first responder, because they're first on the scene, right? Who can get to you quicker than anyone? Well, you. So if you can help yourself, well, then help yourself. So this person is learning a hard lesson that they've got to be their own first responder. They've got to be their own savior. I just heard four alarm fire. Some of you could be seeing 999 and says, I'll have what she's having. So Libra, I don't know if you've been abstaining or if you've just been holding back sexually, but it's apparent that this Capricorn may be following in your footsteps of abstaining, of pulling back from fiery situations. Maybe because you pulled back from this person in the past because it was a fiery situation. I'm not quite sure who left who, but somebody left who. You know your story, Libra. Somebody left somebody in the past, but now this Capricorn is realizing, oh, well, I'll have what the Empress is having, because the Empress seems to be having A better time of it than me, when Harry met Sally. Wow. Listen, that is the original, one of them, the original rom-coms. Okay, when Harry met Sally was the shit, especially the orgasm scene in the restaurant. Classic. Oh, listen, yeah, so, So yeah, no orgasm, so that's why they just showed me that scene. So there's been no orgasm, no excitement, no passion, there's no fire. Even though it was a fiery situation, this Capricorn is not turned on, heated up by the fire of this Aries. Earth energy, and so that's confirmation. This Capricorn definitely did move away from this Aries. Because this Aries did not satisfy this Capricorn like you did. Whether or not you actually had physical sex with this Capricorn, you may have had mental sex with this Capricorn. You're still on this Capricorn's mind, Libra. One more card, please, angels. We'll take three. I'll have what she's having. It's a Sicilian message. It means Luca Brasi sleeps with the fishes. Wow, from The Godfather. Listen. So somebody went sleeping with the fishes. We have this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. So there's a lot of fishy shit going on here. And fish remind me of pregnancy, of fertility. Someone here may be Sicilian, Italian. So this Capricorn may have received message from on high that something was fishy with this Aries, that this Aries may have been sleeping with the fishes, with a Pisces, or a water sign. This is water energy. Mrs. I fart in your general direction, from Monty Python and the Holy Grail. So this person got wrapped up with a snake, a whole python that tried to constrict the shit out of them, but this Capricorn broke out of the clutches, the coils of this snake, this Aries, that possibly went and messed with a Pisces. Because they were cheating on them, and they were just breeding foulness in this Capricorn's air. They were taking them in a shitty ass direction. So this Capricorn said, yep, hold up right there. Let me stop this celebration. Hold on, put your glass down. Put your glass down, because we're not celebrating this shit anymore. You see the graduation caps up at the top? So this Capricorn broke free. They graduated, Libra. This Capricorn's not blowing no smoke. So the Capricorn told the Aries, like, you know, I wasn't playing with you, but you playing with me, so I'm gonna have to cut this. It says, whatever you do, don't fall asleep, from A Nightmare on Elm Street. So yeah, this Capricorn woke up to this Rocky Horror Picture Show. And that is confirmation on the Aries energy. That is fire there. So yeah, it was a nightmare. So we have 87, 88, 84, 89. The 80s are popping. 80s babies. So this Capricorn woke up to the bullshit that this Aries was trying to spin them into. This Aries that could have gotten mixed up with the Pisces. So this Capricorn has changed, Libra. Let's check into some emotions here and see what's going on. Angels, what's on the emotional spectrum? What's going on? We have sorry. We have calm. What else? We have kind. We want these angels. Special. Libra, you're so special. This Capricorn thinks you're special. We have disappointed. One more, please. Tonight. We have frustrated. Well, I guess that's my energy, but anyways. We have sorry. And so not only does this person want to apologize for laughing then, Libra. And this is water energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. So this person is in their emotions. Not only are they sorry, Libra, but they've been praying. They've been praying for this cycle to turn itself around. They're praying for your chocolate sauce. Your special brand, your uniqueness, your very essence, Libra. This person is proud of you for the changes you've made in your life. So not only does this person have big eyes for you, a big heart for you, they've been watching you. Libra, you've just been calm about situations. You're not stirred. It says, I drink your milkshake. You know, you shake up, milkshake up. So you're calm. You've maintained a level of serenity, a level of peace in healing through this situation. This is under the hermit. So Libra, you could have even taken yourself inside. Physically and metaphysically. After the course of this separation. I see some of you smirking. You're due some flowers, Libra. Somebody wants to give you flowers. Yeah, this person wants to be honest. They want to be honest about the options that they had in the past, the way that they played you, the way that they tried to control you or control how things were going in the connection between you two. Like I said, this person had to look in the mirror. We have the crystal balls. They had to look deep within themselves. And Libra, you've just been on the cool, calm, and collected pathway. This is your energy, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius energy, air energy. Because you saved yourself in this situation. You saved yourself in this situation. You saw that things were heading for a volatile, fiery turn. So now I'm getting that you took off from this person. When you left them, they felt like they had gotten too close to the sun. They felt like they got burnt. They went off and went and did what they did. You may have gone into hermit. They may have gone into hermit for some time. But at some point in time, this person ended up with this Aries and possibly got pregnant by this Aries. And this Aries took off and went and did some fiddling with a Pisces. But they definitely feel like you're special, Libra. They're fired up. They're in Aries energy, this Capricorn. See how things bleed through? They're very disappointed at this situation occurring with this Aries. They're disappointed that they invested. They're disappointed that they took some of that milkshake and not in your mouth. Melts in your hand. Anyways, well, we know where it melted. But Libras. It didn't melt, it actually formulated into a whole nother being. But anywho, back to you, Libras. So this person, this Capricorn, take it if it resonates, could be any sign, but this person was definitely upset that they invested in this Aries and then had to pull back. They had to pull back their investments, their time, their energy, their effort, maybe their kids. Now this Aries could be their spouse, I just heard. So I'm not sure how long you two have been in separation, Libra. This could have been their spouse that they married in the time of separation, or this could be a spouse that they were married to during the time of your connection. I'm trying to figure out why this Pisces is upset about the connection between the Capricorn and the Aries ending. Wow, this is a lot. Okay, so let's talk about this. So Libra, the Pisces that the Aries messed around on the Capricorn with is upset with the Aries because the Aries really feels like the Capricorn is their favorite or their number one. So the Pisces is the side piece. And I guess because the Capricorn has left the Aries, that's causing distortion and angst between the Aries and the Pisces. So the Pisces is upset because really the Pisces is just the side piece and the Aries is all thrown off because the Capricorn has thrown in the towel. This is so much going on right now. Libra, let's see how you're feeling about this situation. Upset about it. I'm talking about adult temper tantrums. Who does this? This person, this Pisces, stomps their feet. How old are we now? How old are we now? They literally pout like a grown-ass child. Like, I understand getting upset. You know, you might get a little huffy and puffy and stuff. No, this person is like an angry three-year-old. This Pisces. Libras, how are you feeling about this situation? Angels, how are my Libras feeling about this situation? Libra, you've been thinking about it because we almost got to the end of the stack. You were thinking about it. It says, yeah, is it okay if I bring my little brother? I promise he won't pull down your pants again. So Libra, you might be having some hesitation around this person. If they are indeed planning to come back and apologize to you, it's almost like they're showing me Linus from Charlie Brown. You know how Linus has his little whoopee blanket that he carries everywhere? It's almost like you want a safeguard around this person because you're not quite sure if this person is telling the truth. And it's like, am I going to catch you lying again? Am I going to catch you in the same energy? You know, because I feel like I got to keep my guard up. So you might be feeling like you need to protect yourself from this person, or at least have some kind of safeguard, or maybe setting boundaries. It says, now is not a good time. My daughter just got her period. Wasn't there blood in the water somewhere? Is this first blood? There will be blood. So there will be blood. This is on top of there will be blood. It says, my daughter just got her period. So Libra, you could just be beginning a new period in your life. Now is not a good time because you've just started a whole fresh cycle. It's like you've been rebirthed. This is a process of rebirth that you went into after this connection and this separation, but you're ready to come out of hermit mode. So it's like you don't have time for the bullshit because you're in the process of this rebirth. You're too cool, calm, and collected. Yeah, there may be blood in the water. People are going to see you because, of course, you're coming out of hermit mode. So you will be seen. But you don't have time for the drama. Four more cards, please. We have sis. Now that's some tea. Spill more and make sure it's hot. Hot. I'm hearing hot like fire. By Aaliyah. So there was some tea. So this tea could be coming to the surface because some shit got too hot to handle. Again, we have the fire truck. There's a lot of flames. There's a lot of fire energy. A lot of fire energy, Libra. You dodged this hot ticket, and this person grabbed it and ran with it. Possibly ran off and had a whole nother human being. Oh, look at that. Three. Thank you, angels. You're so direct. Some of you could be seeing 333. Someone here is 33. It says, everything you just said is the reason I'm back in rehab. What did you say to this Capricorn, Libra? So again, this or what did this Capricorn say? So whatever caused this separation between you and this Capricorn, Libra, this is the reason why you had to give yourself love. You had to be your own first responder because you were first on the scene. Now, whether they dipped off first or you dipped off first, I really think it was you that missed the bullet and dipped off first. But anyway. You feel like this Capricorn coming back around may be triggering. You feel like what this person may come to tell you because they do want to apologize or at least say sorry. Not an apology, they want to say sorry. You feel like what this person may bring back around you may cause you to be triggered, to have to go back into self-help, to have to return back to this hermit energy. It says, I want to say yes, but I feel like you're a Hufflepuff and I'm a full Gryffindor. Now, that is some Harry Potter language. So, this person is a magician with the words, and that's why you're a bit hesitant. That's why you're like, I don't know, if you come back around, you might put my ass back in rehab or therapy. So, this person might have given you a bit of PTSD, Libra. So, you feel like you may be two different animals, I just heard. You and this Capricorn are two different animals. again, you want to say yes, but you feel like if you give in to this person, if you give in to this passion, if you give in to this Capricorn, they may put you back into that hermit energy. It says, shut your Skechers wearing ass up. Well, god dang Libra, if that don't say it all. I'm not sure if someone here wears Skechers, but I just heard Rockport. So someone here wears Rockport shoes. Someone's gonna need some comfortable shoes, all this walking they doing, all this traveling, possibly traveling towards you, or at least truly walking away from this Aries, because again, this Capricorn was stuck, but they made the decision to get out of this devilish energy, to get away from this Aries, and to walk away from the connection they had with them. This was karmic retribution, though, for the transgressions of the past that this Capricorn possibly placed against you. But this twin flame energy is here, Libra. I can't deny it. It's staring me right in the face. So you may not necessarily be wanting to hear from this person. You may feel triggered still by this situation. But this person does want to say sorry. Because gosh darn it, Libra, you are their sexual chocolate and they find you to be quite special. So that's where I'm going to leave you Libras here today. Thank you so very much for your time, your energy, your watch. I love you. I appreciate you. Without you, I would just be talking to myself. So thank you for listening. If you would like to request a personal reading, please scroll down in the description box where you will find that handy dandy information. And if you would like to contribute to the growth and expansion of this channel so that other Libras, other lovely Libras such as yourself, can see and hear these messages to help them on their journey or just in their day or just for entertainment. Take it how it resonates. Please do share these videos. Please like this video. Please hit the subscribe button. Thank you. Thumbs up. Please, Libras, also use your own intuition and discernment to make the very best decisions for your highest good. The Cash App, if you would like to contribute, is $GirlKing, the number 3, the number 6, Tarot, GirlKing36, Tarot, also down in the description box. Libras, I love you. United we stand, together we rise. Holla at your girl.